pod. Side to side.
We're going to do armbar from mount. So Mark would typically defend like that. What I'm looking to do is just shift up ever so slightly. I'm going to look to put my feet towards his hips there. So already, you're kind of getting these elbows nice and exposed. Mark's good like this, he'll know how to defend. It's quite hard to get anything from here. So what we're going to look to do is make sure you've got good balance. If you can at this stage, because we're still quite low, keep the knees out. So Mark starts to bridge. I've got a lot more space to kind of keep good balance. Otherwise, if my knees are close together, I'm likely to roll easier. So I'm going to stay here. Now for this one, what we're going to do, we're going to move the body to the side, move the arm over, and just use your tummy to keep that arm pinned. This knee comes up, arm under the head, and you're looking to scoop this elbow up here. So you're going to pull this elbow all the way up, not necessarily too high, but just so we're in a good position. So you're going to make sure you bring your knee round to the head, and I'm going to pull this foot round. What you've got to be mindful of is that you want to keep a lot of pressure still on Mark's chest. So instead of just lifting my leg up, I'm going to put my hamstring down. So I'm maintaining a lot of pressure like that. So we're going to end up in this position here. Mark's arms are here. Let's assume he's not defending the other way. Let's keep it like that one. Let's keep it easy for the moment. So I'm going to reach under, grab my gi, put my fist down on this side of the hip here. As I up fours, I'm going to pull this knee around here. Let's keep close to his face. There. And then pull back on his head. The purpose of this is just to keep his body off balance. So at no point is he ever nice and flat. Yeah. It makes it hard for him to move, hard for him to bridge. So from here, as we look to fall back, underhook the leg. Keep everything nice and tight. And arm bars on. Quite often, Mark will defend. We should be able to defend. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and get this arm now. So from here, I'm going to feed this hand in and grab this. Now I'm going to try and shoot round and get this for the arm bar. So what I need to do, I need to put my fist down over here. Notice I'm going up here somewhere, so it's above his headline. There's a reason for that, I'll show you in a second. So hands up here, and as we shoot round, the leg comes across. Don't let go of the arm, this hand here. Comes round, captures the arm, and we come back to a nice tight arm bar. Now, like I said before, the hand comes up here, not down here. If it comes down here, my arse is going to hit my arm as I'm going to come round, and I find it a bit of a struggle. So I've got to think, well, where's my bum going to go? My bum's going to go around here somewhere, so my hand needs to get out of the way of my bum. So.
I know the rules, I
always have
nice.
Stop, I'll lose you. I'll look back and go back. First time's the best ride.
What's going on YouTube? Welcome to the vlog. So join you on a sunny Saturday. Just got done with jiu-jitsu training in the gi. One of the brown belts, Dan, took it. Shout out to Dan. Some nice little armbar details there. Hopefully everyone enjoyed that. And then I showed one round of me rolling. That was with Tess. So big shout out to Tess, as Tess is leaving for London very shortly. So the time is currently just after 12. Beautiful, beautiful day here in England, and I'm gonna go get some grub, so find out where we're going. All right guys, decided to go to the supermarket on the way home, super easy, convenient, and we're gonna go for what is, this is a big thing to say, but might be my favorite food currently, sushi. Y'all don't know about that protein. Got the goods, now just need to find somewhere to eat them.
Hey, hey, she said, do you love me? I tell her only partly, I only love my bed and my mom, I'm sorry, 50 dub.
So guys, as you can see, it is the royal wedding today in England. Prince Harry marrying that Rachel from Suits, Meghan Markle, but I'll always know her as Rachel. To be honest though, this might be an unpopular opinion. I don't really give a flying bleep. So I'm back home now. I was gonna find a park or something to eat and relaxing, but I've bought some yogurt and it doesn't really seem like a smart idea to have the yogurt outdoors, so I've just brought it out to show you quickly. I have no idea what this brand is called. I presume it's just from the UK, but it is the nicest brand of yogurt that I've had. It's a gourmet live yogurt. I haven't tried this flavor before. Raspberry, passion fruit, and mango. R.O.P. though. But before that is the spicy salmon sushi. 9 rolls, got the avo in there.
They don't treat wild pigs in Texas like you would treat like a deer that you shot, that you hunted down, took a long time to track, and you had to, you know, get into perfect position, and you cherish that meat. Wild pigs, they're shooting them out of helicopters. I mean, I'm sure you've seen those Ted Nugent videos.
Oh, yeah, I do it.
Do you do that? Yeah, I do that. Heli hunting?
Yeah. Well, there'll be farms. So a farm in, let's say, Central Texas.
That food went down a treat there, guys, having the spicy sushi followed by the cool yogurt. Absolute winning combination, complete treat. And I was listening to some Joe Rogan podcasts. Really find that relaxing while I'm eating lunch. And to follow up, we're smashing through the fruit. Got some blackberries, blueberries, raspberries, and an apple. Booyah. Listen to this, guys. The sound of a heavy ghee caked in sweat. Disgusting. So, guys, it's a little bit later. It's close to 3 o'clock. Just had a post-lunch chill out, but I thought I'd show you this quickly. So these are the sponges that I use in my hand wraps. They're kind of thicker, but after a while, they start to lose some of the spring in it, some of the denseness, and then the cracks start to happen as well. So I'm gonna show you what I do to get a new one of these. So this is what they look like originally. This is the brand again. I presume it's UK brand. They come in packs of two different colors, and as you can see, they're in one big chunk. So what I normally do with one of these strips is cut it into three. So I cut the first one, and then I use that as a kind of measuring stick for the other two. So if I just get the first one roughly, so it looks about right. Line it up, do the second one. So then to match it up, you can just trim the edges out like so. I like trimming them out like this, just so that it's kind of consistent, so on each hand they have the same amount. But you can see here, it's not too big, it's not as big as like a yellow sponge, and then it has a nice density to it as well. So there we go, it looks like a weird Hulk sandwich. 3 symmetrical, nice new hand wrap sponges, boom. So now I've done that, next thing on my to-do list is I've got a pack. I'm going on a road trip tomorrow, I'm going all the way to Swansea for a week of training at the Chris Reese Academy. Some of these guys have been in the vlog before. They're part of the Team UK that I met through the Worlds in Bahrain. The head coach, Chris, is really good. He cornered me at my last fight at the Worlds, so I'm excited to train under him a bit. Ash also part owns the gym, who's the EBI vet in one of my previous vlogs. We've got the guys Scott, Ben, there's other fighters, other pro fighters, and amateur. I think the top name out of there is Brett Johns, who is, I believe, top 15 in the UFC at bantamweight. So a lot of good names there, a lot of good bods. So I'll show you some of the essential MMA kit I'm going to take. Also, I don't know why, you can probably see I've had a massive breakout in spots like around here and here. I think it might be because I spilled some like cleaning chemicals on me at work, but I never normally get spots. But you gotta roll with the punches sometimes, guys. So the plan is take my trusty shin guards for booting people and protecting myself from getting booted. Take my 16-ounce gloves, which I can use for sparring, and pads. If I take the smaller gloves, then I can't spar in them, which are only 12 ounces. General rule of thumb, you should have 14 to 16-ounce gloves for sparring, depending how big you are. I'm also going to take a pair of MMA gloves. I switched these out. I've got quite a few pairs, because the ones I've been using for the last few weeks have been getting kind of stinky, so I thought I'd use an older pair that don't smell so bad. As well, I'm gonna take a few pairs of hand wraps in case I can't wash it out there. Need to protect the wrist. Got these new sponges that I just showed you guys. The most important bit of kit anytime is the mouth guard, obviously. Shout out Safe Jaws for supplying that one. And then as well, I've got my head guard, keep my ears safe. Always got my flip-flops, clean feet. But that's pretty much it, guys. It's all I really need to train. Along with that, I've got a ton of sports gear I've just kind of accumulated over the years. So this is kind of more just general stuff like vests, tracky bottoms, hoodies and stuff, some shorts in there. And this is a bit more like MMA specific. So we got like shorts, which aren't too bad, but I prefer wearing Lycra and packing Lycra because smaller, lighter, easier, like less folding and stuff, and it washes a lot easier too, more hygienic. So I've got a lot of leggings, a lot of shorts. I mean, you guys have probably seen what I wear in the videos anyway. Right, guys, all done now. I hate packing, but it's one of those things, you've got to get it done. So Got a nice suitcase. I'd always rather overpack than underpack. It's mainly training kit on there, and then I've got a little bit of normal clothes. As well as that, I'm going to have a load of these carrier bags in case I can't do any washing, have to have some dirty laundry spill over. And then as well, I'm taking a sleeping bag. Trendy, looks like a wasp. I hate wasps, but it's all good. So the plan is now, guys, gonna go for a run and I will catch up with you in the next clip.
Near the end of my run, check this out. This is my little spot in the village near the park where kind of towards the end I like to get a little extra in, a little workout in. Sometimes I do pull-ups. Today I'm gonna do some knee raises. Bit of core, bit shreddy. Did a set of 15, I'll do three more of those, so 60 reps total. So behind the scenes of the vlog, guys, put my phone in my shoe to film that there. Quite proud of myself in a weird way. Bit of ingenuity shown, but serious commitment to the video, please drop it a like.
Right, guys, all done with the run now. Not gonna lie, feeling pretty hungry. I'm gonna have dinner at home, but I feel like a snack and I wanna go pick up a chocolate bar for later, so gonna go on a quick little expedition. Right, people, I've smashed it here, got through my first stop with a Kinder Bueno and a Dime bar. Gone a bit piggy, got two there, but two of my favorite chocolate bars ever. On to the next stop. Yes, the drive through. I love it, I absolutely love it. Come here, wrap of the day, come here, my friend. Back from the adventure now, saving these chocolate bars for later, but we're getting into the snack, the free snack before dinner. I'm absolutely starving. This is the wrap of the day from McDonald's. It's £1.99, shut up and take my money. Looks something like that. So this is a sweet chili chicken wrap, was craving it. Next up is a sesame seed bagel with a silly amount of hummus and some cucumber. Here's the main event of the evening. We've got a fancy steak today. A Aberdeen Angus sirloin, 32 days matured, dry. We've got some fine tip asparagus, which was cooked in olive oil, salt and pepper. That's pretty much my favorite veggie at the moment. And we got some leftover Moroccan hummus, just a tiny bit of that. On the side is gonna be the red hot sauce and some mayo. Right, guys, that steak was banging, completely hit the spot. See me right off, perfect end to the day. But I've had a good day, kind of a typical Saturday for me. Hope you guys have enjoyed coming along for the ride. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.